As kids head back to school and you start thinking about quick breakfast fixes, how about sprayable pancakes? Are they just as good as the regular? And I'm Stella Inger. Thanks so much for being with us. We begin tonight with a developing story. A Riverside County Sheriff's deputy.
Well, we usually associate trolleys with San Francisco, but now they're coming to the valley. That's according to the city of India.
Welcome back. You haven't seen the last of Michael Phelps. After swimming away with 8 gold medals at the Beijing Summer Games, he says he plans on diving into his next challenge.
And for gas thieves, let me show you. It's as easy as getting a hold of your gas tank and getting away with everything inside.
Kathy, I guess the big question today is, who's better for your portfolio?
Well, you know, a lot of people have a viewpoint.
When you see what this new place has to offer, you may be tempted to stop by on Saturday.
The stalemate in California history is finally over. The state legislature approves a budget 81 days into our fiscal year. Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger says he will sign the $143 billion spending plan next week, most likely Monday. When the budget is signed, the state can resume payments to schools, medical clinics, daycare centers, and state vendors that haven't been paid since July.
Well, I'm very glad that the legislature.
The new budget will cut over $7 billion in state spending, including reductions in public transit. It also includes lower than projected education funding, but schools will be fully funded under Proposition 98's minimum funding guarantee. We're learning new information tonight about a plane crash in Russia yesterday that killed everyone on board. Officials now say engine failure is to blame, not terrorism. The Aeroflot Boeing 737 was on its way from Moscow to the Siberian city of Perm when it went down, killing 88 people. Americans were among those killed, as well as citizens of France, Turkey, Switzerland, Germany, Italy, and Latvia. There you see emergency workers at the crash scene. Now, airline representatives say the pilots of the plane lost communication with air traffic controllers at about 3 in the morning. This is the worst crash involving a Russian airliner since 2006. Metrolink says dispatchers in Pomona tried to warn the train's engineer that he had violated a stop order and was on his way toward a head-on collision. However, that warning came too late.
Authorities say the
Democratic presidential candidate Barack Obama raises a record $66 million in August, handing him a big advantage over John McCain in the closing stretch of the White House race. And 2 months before the elections, opinion polls showed that the race between Obama and McCain is dead even. And Obama's spokesman says the August figure was helped by 500,000 new donors. Chris, Andy, if you're a parent, you're probably wondering, how can video games benefit my child? Well, the study says they can actually make your child a better person.
What do you think about video games?
I love it. It's like the best thing ever.
Jared Andre is just one of many teens who enjoys playing video games. And in a surprise twist, a study shows that parents shouldn't stop their kids from spending time in front of a screen.
I think that my parents need to see it so that they're not always on me and my brother, because they think they're horrible, you know, they're old school.
Researchers say the study shows that at least 97% of teens play video games. They're playing them frequently at hours on end, and more than half of them usually play with someone else, which means they're interacting with others as opposed to being antisocial.
Now, the study shows the most popular games are not violent. In fact, the study says kids prefer to play racing games, sports, and puzzles.
There is positive. His reflexes, his coordination, his problem solving, and all that is dealt with video games.
And that's exactly what the study says. Playing video games helps kids become more civic-minded and teaches them how to overcome obstacles. But since the study says kids aren't really interested in violent games, we wanted to see what were some of the top-selling games. Looks like Grand Theft Auto came in at number one, one of the most violent games out there. The second, also a violent fighting game. However, the next three in line, Mario Kart, Wii Fit, and Guitar Hero 3 do support the study, but that doesn't change the opinion of some, like this mother of two boys.
I like to, for them to show me what is good for them out of the video games. What are they learning from it other than getting carpal tunnel at a young age?
And that is an interesting story. So I guess what the study is trying to say, parents, don't worry, your kids aren't wasting their time.
Well, it's really about balance, I think.
I mean,
maybe it's not horrible for them, but also get out, play real sports, interact with real kids.
And that's what a lot of parents think. Andy, federal officials say they launched an investigation into the baking company 2 years ago. This after receiving a tip from local law enforcement that the business was allegedly hiring illegal immigrants.
ICE agents move in on the Palm Springs Baking Company, arresting 51 suspected illegal immigrants, 31 women and 20 men, but later releasing 24 of them for humanitarian reasons, for example, being a primary caregiver of a young child. George Guzman, assistant special agent in charge of ICE, says officials started their investigation into the business when they found out the company was allegedly hiring illegal immigrants in exchange for a payment of $3,000 for each worker.
Aside from those administrative arrests, we have arrested one individual supervisor, Margarita Hernandez Aviles, for criminal violations for continuing to employ an illegal alien.
The 52-year-old woman's son is on scene and outraged.
They want to do a raid, do it, but don't blame it on my mom. You know, it's okay, I don't care. Take whoever you want to take. My mom is a legal resident. She's not taking money from nowhere. She's working honestly. That's not her fault. That's the owner's fault for not checking the papers right.
Martha Escobar says her 19-year-old niece of Desert Hot Springs was arrested. She says her niece is from Guatemala and is in the country illegally. Now Escobar fears for her niece's infant.
I don't know why they do this, because we're working for take care of the family. We don't do nothing bad over here. She don't pay nothing for work over here because she's working for money. I don't think she got $3,000 for work.
I'm the chief executive officer of the company, and I can look at everybody and say, hey, we've done everything right and have great employees. We've worked with the INS in the past. I'll work with them now. I haven't even talked to them.
Officials also just informed us that they have arrested another person on criminal charges, 36-year-old Alicia Ramirez, a former supervisor for the company. Now, if you're trying to find out about a family member arrested today, you can log on to our website, cbstv2.com. Live in the newsroom, Stella Inger, KPSP Local 2 News.